If we could tackle diagnostic errors related to cancer, infections, and vascular events like strokes and heart attack, we would have tackled probably half or more of all the patient harms associated with diagnostic errors.
5 years ago, with a generous gift from Michael Armstrong, we formed the Armstrong Institute with a very clear purpose: to partner with patients, their loved ones, and others to end preventable harm. And today, we're going to extend the reach of the Armstrong Institute to include delayed and missed diagnoses. And we're going to bring our full force and research capabilities to address that problem.
Almost every American will experience a diagnostic error at least one point in their lifetime.
Sometimes with devastating consequences. There are some estimates that suggest there are more than 12 million diagnostic errors a year, up to one-third of which result in serious patient harms, including permanent morbidity or death.
The Armstrong Institute Center for Diagnostic Excellence is the first center of this kind in the world devoted entirely to the issue of improving diagnosis in healthcare. The center is going to focus on three main areas associated with what I call the big three problems: missed cancer, missed infections, and missed vascular events, and in particular, missed diagnosis of stroke in the emergency department.
In the Patient Safety Institute, we have developed a lot of techniques, systems, and technology in order to do the analysis on preventable harm. There's a lot of theories, there's a lot of opinions, there's a lot of judgments. We are simply fact data driven in the Institute.
Diagnostic errors are pervasive because medicine is difficult. Diagnosis is made often under high amounts of uncertainty with limited information and limited time. Right now, people think of diagnosis as an individual sport like singles tennis. We need to make it a team sport because diagnosis really is a team sport. At the end of the day, we need involvement not only by physicians, but nurses, physical therapists, other allied health professionals to help us get the best diagnosis for our patients.
And we need to turn this into a supportive system and culture that leads to correct, timely diagnosis, correct, timely treatment, and improved patient outcomes. That's really what we want to accomplish in this space. Improving the diagnostic process is not only possible, but it also represents a moral, professional, and public health imperative. That's really something we can't ignore.
So I think the Armstrong Institute is uniquely qualified to tackle this issue, really because of its proven track record in bringing together teams of people from different disciplines, having them work together in a concerted learning lab kind of space, and then ultimately take solutions that they've developed, implement them in practice, and disseminate them broadly. And that's what we need for diagnostic errors.
It's really about improving patient outcomes and reducing patient harms.
The key takeaway is that diagnostic error is a major public health problem that we all need to deal with. But if we work together,
we can do this.